Hi, Shelley. How are you?
Hi, John. I'm doing well. And you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for asking. Did you know that you can do things to lower your cancer risk?
No, I didn't know that. What can I do?
Well, today, I'm sharing different things that we can all do to help prevent cancer and improve our health. First, you should avoid sitting for an extended period of time.
That might be hard for me because I spend most of my day sitting at work.
Well, you could try taking short walks during your breaks. And some people even use standing or moving desks.
Wow, those are great ideas. I'll ask my manager about my options.
Second, it is also important to eat fruits and vegetables regularly. And you can start with one at each meal and work your way up to 5 servings a day.
5 servings a day? Oh my, that's a lot. I guess I could start by adding a fruit to my lunch.
Yes, and depending on what you use, salads are an effective way to get multiple servings in one meal. Third, do not drink alcohol every day. And do not drink too much at one time.
How much is too much? I do like wine and other drinks.
Well, according to the FDA dietary guidelines, men should limit their intake to no more than 2 drinks per day. Women should not have more than 1 drink per day.
Okay, I got this one under control. I usually only drink on the holidays.
Fourth, if you smoke, try to avoid all tobacco products. And if you do not smoke, do not start.
Okay. I'm not a smoker because the smoke makes it really hard for me to breathe, but I do have a friend who has been smoking for years and has struggled to quit many times.
Yes, quitting smoking is a tough habit to break, but there are resources that can help your friend quit smoking. I can give you a list today.
Perfect.
Fifth, you should also exercise regularly. When you are overweight or obese, your risk for cancer increases.
What? I didn't know that. I have a neighbor who is really into taking daily walks. Maybe I could join him.
Sixth, you can lower your risk of skin cancer by protecting your skin and eyes from the sun's rays.
Oh, I'm not worried about the sun.
Well, most skin cancers result from exposure to sunlight or UV rays, including artificial UV rays like those found in tanning beds. Even people with darker skin can get skin cancer.
Oh, wow. So what should I do to protect myself?
Well, you can use things like sunscreen, hats, and sunglasses. Lastly, stay up to date with your regular cancer screening exams at the times your healthcare provider suggests. Your age, sex, family history, and risk factors will determine which cancer screenings you are eligible for and when you need to get screened.
Thanks so much for the information. Where can I get this information again if I forget?
Well, here's our brochure. And you can learn more about cancer screening and prevention by calling Cancer Action Prevention and Engagement at Yale or CAPE at 203-200-3030.